Dahil sa nakatikim ng pambabatikos ang miyembro ng LGBTQ+ na si Jude Bacalso. Mula sa publiko at maging sa kapwa LGBTQ member nito ay minabuti na lamang niyang manghingi ng paumanhin sa netizens. Matapos niyang 2 oras na patayuin ang server ng restaurant dahil sa pagtawag umano sa kanya ng sir. Earlier today, I sat down to quietly settle the matter with the restaurant management, one crew, and the store supervisor who were present last night. The waiter I had a disagreement with was not present. After each one of us aired our sides, I am happy to share that we have agreed to pursue together more inclusive practices in the restaurant. I also realized that in the impassioned pursuit of my advocacy, I could have done with a little measure of kindness. Sadly, quite absent in the raucous, this has all unnecessarily created when it was made public without our knowledge. I made a personal apology to the group present and requested if I may do so for the concerned waiter. I am also making it very public with a post as it has become quite public fodder. I also want to underscore that the management always had the back of their personnel with constant communication with me on behalf of their employees, who are all treated as family, as I know personally from their history. To quote the supervisor, they served me as the best they could even if it was most difficult for them to do so. I would like also to reiterate that I did not demand that the waiter stand for the whole length of time, as I was explaining my side of the gender sensitivity issue. It was he who chose to stand in front of me as a waiter for input from management, who I attempted to contact. My apologies also to the rest of the staff who are disheartened by the way things have escalated, as well as to the customers present at that time. This is a huge chunk of humble pie that I must ingest, because I have heard, may we start herewith, as the supervisor pointed out, an unfilled path to reconciliation, and we hope you will be able to allow us and yourselves to do so unhampered, so we may all learn and heal from this.
Sa mga hindi nakakaalam, si Jude Bacalso ang Cebu-based writer na pinag-uusapan ngayon dahil sa pagkadismaya ng netizen nakakita sa kanya at sa ginawa nito sa server ng restaurant. Base sa post ng concerned netizen na si John Calderon, alas 4 ng hapon niya umano unang nakita ang waiter na nakatayo sa harapan ni Jude. Kaya naman inakala daw nitong nag-uusap lamang ang dalawa. Ngunit nang muli daw makita ni John ang waiter na nasa parehong pwesto pa din kung saan niya ito nakita makalipas ang 2 oras. Dito na daw naglakas ng loob tanongin ni John si Jude kung siya ba ang may-ari ng restaurant. Pambalang naman daw siyang sinagot ni Jude ng bakit hindi daw nito tanungin ang waiter na nakatayo sa harap niya. Dahil dito ay kinausap na ni John ang waiter at tinanong kung ano daw bang nangyari. At hinagot naman siya ng waiter at sinabing na tawag umano niya na sir, si Jude Bacalso. Wala namang umanong magawa ang mga kasama ng waiter sa trabaho dahil kilalang malapit daw itong si Jude sa may-ari ng restaurant. Tala, hindi naman kumbinsido ang publiko sa paghingi ng paumanhin ni Jude Bacalso. The sentiment seems apologetic, but the ego in the background rose so loud. It is not written, but this is just so, tell me you are not sorry without telling me you are not sorry. I support the LGBTQ community, but if I impose to call him ma'am or madam, would be a great disrespect to my belief. The Bible never said anything about them, or call him he if she is a she, or she if he is a he. The word of the Lord has always been the same as it was before, now and forever. Your right ends where the rights of the others begins. I was there to understand you, but this, I did not demand that the waiter stand for the whole length of time, as I was explaining my side of the gender sensitivity issue. It was he who chose to stand in front of me
as we waited for input from management, who I attempted to contact. Sir, you were ranting, of course he will stand there unless you could have told Joe to go back and discuss the matter with management. Your ego is on top of your head. Go back to earth.
You're still blaming the server in the case. Kung wala pag-iposto nga incident, basin magpadayon ka ana nga attitude. You can do better. Sa bata pa ko, kabatin na jud ko ana imong name. So disappointing nga ingani diya imong personality. Public figure man ka, so hopefully mahimo kang good example of kindness. Sa kadto nga situation, murag kulang jud ka sa chill. Manong jud bakalso, you don't own the reality and people don't owe you respect. Yet, the waiter gave you one by calling your sir, let alone compel their speech to satisfy your delusions and ideologies. You aren't discriminated or misgendered. Ikaw ang nag-misgender sa sarili mo by portraying to be a woman when in fact, you're a 100% man. Mukha kang lalaki, sir, kahit mag-makeup ka pa at mag-heels. Jude, I can still sense arrogance. Please remember you are not and will never be a woman. You have chosen a path and you cannot impose on the larger community to adjust to what you want and how you want to be addressed. We did not get degrees just for our pronouns to be messed up. Don't you think your so-called advocacy is an insult to our intelligence as a bigger community? It is you who are not the waiter. Calling you, sir, was just appropriate. And the one who made this issue public, glad that person did, otherwise you will never learn to bite the humble pie and know your boundaries.